Hi guys, welcome to our channel Shubhada Group of Education Sirsi. You are watching Satish Sir's Physics videos for KCET and NEET. Look at the next problem. A and B are two concentric circular conductors of center O and carrying current I1 and I2 as shown in the figure. If the ratio of their radii is 1:2, the ratio of the flux densities at O due to A and B is 1:3, then the ratio of the currents is the question, correct? So you know that how to find out the magnetic field at the center. So I have given the hint for you. Magnetic field due to the circular coil must be equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi into theta I divided by R, correct? So we here we do have two different concentric circular coils. That's the reason why we will get the two different magnetic field at the center. So B1 must be equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi. Now theta is going to be full circle, right? That's the reason theta is going to be how much? 2 pi into I1 divided by R1. Okay, similarly B2 must be equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 pi again I2 divided by R2. Clear? So now I will get B1 and B2 now. So let me take the ratio of them. So B1 divided by B2, that must be equal to mu naught by 4 pi, mu naught by 4 pi gone, 2 pi gone. We left with I1 by I2 into what? R2 is inversely proportional, that's the reason why R2 by R1. Clear? So B1 by B2 is given as how much it is? 1:3, right? 1:3. The ratio of the flux density is 1:3 is given here. So that's 1/3. That must be equal to I1 divided by I2. R2 by R1 is how much? It is 2:1. 1:2 is nothing but R1 by R2. So that's R2 by R2, R2 by R1 must be, it is 2:1. So that's the reason why I1 by I2, that must be equal to 3 goes to the denominator here. So that's the reason why 1/6. So that's the reason why 1/6, option A is the right answer for this question. The next problem says that an electric current passes through a long straight wire at a distance of 5 cm from the wire. The magnetic field is B. The field at 20 cm from the wire would be. See, clearly we have discussed while discussing the synopsis for magnetic current or the magnetic field and magnetic current. Okay, so suppose if we have a long straight conductor, there will be the magnetic field surrounding it once there is a flow of electric current through it, current I. And we have calculated the value of the magnetic field B equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi d by using the Biot-Savart's law as well as Ampere's circuital law, correct? So let me use the same rule here. So they have given that at distance it was 5 centimeter. At a distance of 5 centimeter, the magnetic field is B. Okay, so that's the reason why I can say that B is equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi into 5 centimeter. Okay, so let me take the new magnetic field, which is at a distance of 20 centimeter is B dash, equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi into 20 centimeter. Okay, so let me take the ratio of them. B dash divided by B, okay, divide this by this one. Now B dash divided by B, that must be equal to mu naught I, mu naught pi cancel, 2 pi cancel. We left with what? 5 centimeter divided by 20 centimeter. So that's the reason why. So how much you'll get here? B dash must be equal to B divided by 4. 5 ones are 5 fours are here, that's the reason it is B by 4. Option B is the right answer. The next problem says that two long straight wires are set parallel to each other. Each carries a current of I in the same direction and the separation between them is 2R. So the separation between them is 2R here. Okay, so the intensity of the magnetic field at the midway, in the sense they're expecting the value of the magnetic field at distance of R from the left long straight conductor, and from right conductor also it is R only, because R plus R is will give you 2R as a distance here, correct? You know that the magnetic field due to the two conductors carrying the current in the same direction must be equal to mu naught I1 I2 divided by 2 pi into distance D, correct? See, but if you look at the direction of the magnetic field here, since it is current carrying like this, so the magnetic field, by using the Fleming's right hand rule, it says that the magnetic field is into the plane of the paper at point P. But due to this conductor, magnetic, the same rule I'm using, the magnetic field is out of the plane of the paper. That's the reason why both the magnetic fields, say B1 and B2, are cancelled each other with the same magnitude. So that's the reason why the resultant magnetic field B must be equal to how much? Zero. So that's the reason why option C is the right answer. Zero is the right answer for this question. The next problem says that a part of a long wire carrying a current I is bent into a circle of radius R as shown in the figure. The net magnetic field at the center O of the circular loop is the question. Correct? This is a good problem. So we do have two different segments here. One is a straight line like this and one was a circular segment like this. Correct? So we know that due to this circular coil, let me take B1 as the magnetic field. There will be two different magnetic field. One is due to the circular loop and one more magnetic field will be due to the straight conductor here. Okay, so B1 is the magnetic field due to the circular conductor. You know that mu naught divided by 4 pi into theta I. Theta is nothing but 2 pi again. Current I is flowing. I divided by how much? Theta I divided by, it is, distance is R. Correct? So that's the reason why it must be equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi R. Okay, this is the B1. B2 is the magnetic field due to the straight conductor. Okay, B2 is the magnetic field due to this straight conductor here. That is going to be mu naught I divided by 2 pi d. D is the distance, that is R here. Okay, so this is equation number 1 and this is the equation number 2 here. I hope that you understood. Now look at the direction. They are expecting the net magnetic field, right? Net magnetic field. Okay, they are expecting the net magnetic field. See, at this point, due to circular coil, the magnetic field is outside the plane of the paper, right? Outside the plane of the paper, because you have to do the same rule, Fleming's right hand rule. Again, due to this conductor, that is what, straight conductor, again the magnetic field is what? Outward. So that's the reason why between B1 as well as B2, there is an angle of how much? Only 0 degree. Okay, why the angle is very much important while calculating the magnetic field, net magnetic field, is that as the magnetic field is a vector quantity, we need to use the vector addition to solve this problem. Correct? So that's the reason why the net magnetic field must be equal to square root of B1 square plus B2 square plus 2 times B1 into B2 into cos theta. So cos theta is, theta is going to be how much? 0 degrees. So cos 0 is 1 here. So that's the reason why it is B1 square plus B2 square plus 2 times B1 B2. It is nothing but A square plus B square plus 2 times AB. In the sense, it is nothing but B1 plus B2 the whole square. That is what B1 plus B2 is. Okay, so now I am adding a B1 as well as B2 now. So here B1 is nothing but 2 pi. Here there is no pi here because it is mu naught I divided by only 2R. Okay, so I am adding them. That is equal to mu naught I divided by 2R plus how much? B2 is how much now? B2 is mu naught I divided by 2 pi into R. So now here the pi is required for B1 now. Let me multiply it by pi and divide by pi. Okay, so denominator is same now, 2 pi R. So I am going to add the numerator now. So mu naught I is common and it is 1 plus pi divided by 2 pi r. Okay, so mu naught I divided by 2 pi r into pi plus 1. So option C is the right answer for this question. Move to the next problem here. Okay, a long solenoid carrying a current produces a magnetic field B along its axis. If the current is doubled and the number of turns per unit per centimeter is halved, the new value of the magnetic field is. While discussing the synopsis on magnetic field, we have studied that magnetic field due to solenoid on its axis must be equal to mu naught n into I. Okay, so n is nothing but number of turns per unit length. Correct? So that's the reason why this is B. So the new magnetic field must be equal to, so we are halving
the number of turns per centimeter, the we are going to twice, I mean since we're doubling, we are doubling what? The current, correct? So doubling the current, so this is 2 times I, so that's 2 going to be cancelled, we're left with what? Again mu naught n into I. This is equivalent to what? B only. So therefore B dash must be equal to B. So that's the reason why option A is the right answer for this question. So thank you very much for watching this video. Kindly watch this video, as well as please try to share this video with your friends and colleagues. And if you have any doubt, just make a comment on the comment box so that I can help you with. And thank you very much. Thanks for watching this video, as well as wish you all the best for your examinations. Good luck. Thank you.